Alright guys, just a short video. Apologies I haven't uploaded the second part of the shock leader test yet. The weather's been terrible. So I thought I'd do a quick review of these pocket scale balance. It's a MH500 series, which means it weighs up to 500 grams with 0.1 resolution, gram resolution. I thought it'd just be handy for measuring weights and stuff. So it cost me $4.99. I actually saw John Holden use it in one of the videos, so as you can see, we'll take a wee closer look at it here, see what kind of features it has, but it's very good value for $4.99. Okay, so let's take a wee look at this pocket scale MH500. Weighs up to 500 grams of 0.1 gram resolution. I just thought it'd be handy for measuring out lead weights or spools from reels, etc. It comes in a wee case. Takes two AAA batteries, has a standard tear function, as most balances do. Press tear to zero it. It does, let's see units here, grams, TL, which I'm not too sure what that is, ounces, carats, and grains, which is used for very small measurements. Has a backlight and also has a pieces function, which if you tell it, say you have a bag of beads or whatever and you measure the weight of one bead, you put that on the scale, it'll work out the amount of beads in the wee bag you have or whatever, which is pretty handy. So all in all, for $4.99 it can't be bad, but that's the important thing is it's accurate. So I have some calibration weights in work, so I'm going to test them out on this, so let's go and do that first. Some calibration weights here. Official calibration weight, so let's give them a wee go. So 1 gram, 1.0, 2 grams, 2.0, quite impressed, must be 1 or 2, 5 grams, 5.0, 10 grams, 10.0, 20 grams, 20.0, 50 grams, 50.1, it's only 0.1 gram out, 100 gram, 100.2. So all in all, for my needs, for I'd say it's, these are proper accredited weights for calibration, so it's very accurate. So it'll do for me. Well, that turned out to be pretty accurate for the price of the thing, for £4.99. I wasn't expecting that kind of accuracy. There actually is a calibration mode. Now, unfortunately, I don't have the proper... You need a 500 gram weight to start off with to calibrate the thing, which I don't have. But for my needs, it's more than adequate. So I thought, well, let's measure some lead weights just to see what they're like. For a laugh. I know when... World Casting Championships, they have to be within a couple of grams of the designated weight, which say 150 gram weight needs to be sort of between 148 and 152. So I thought I'd have a look at some of my weights here. We box with a few weights to take out to practice with me. So let's try a long tail 175. Nearly. So I'm actually casting them more than I need to. Let's try a short tail 150. These are all UK Hooks leads. 151.9. So that would pass for casting in competition, I would say. Let's see if I have a 125. No 125 is my wee box there at the moment. Try 100 gram. 102.7, just a wee bit over. So it's just handy to know, because sometimes when the writing wears off, sometimes I maybe it's just old age or whatever, sometimes I can't really tell the difference between a 150 and a 125. So it'll be just handy to have that there to measure weights and also various different types of spools and reels and stuff. So if you fancy a nice wee pocket balance, check one of these out. They're on eBay for $4.99, I think, including free delivery. So cheers.